Confused about what trailer plug you need? Our simple explanation explains all. Hi, I'm Briohny from Accelerate Auto Electrics and Air Conditioning on the Sunshine Coast. One of the most common questions we get asked as auto electricians is what the different types of trailer plugs are and what each one is used for. Today we're going to take a look at the most common options for trailer plugs, the 5-pin, 7-pin, 12-pin and also the Anderson plug. They're called 5, 7 and 12 plugs because they connect 5, 7 or 12 wires on your car to your caravan or trailer, i.e. if you turn the indicator on in your car, the first pin connects the signal in the car to the trailer indicator and makes the trailer indicator work. So let's take a look at each plug. First up we have the 5 pin, which only comes in round. In Andrew's 20 years of being an auto electrician on the Sunshine Coast, he hasn't actually ever seen one of these. They are definitely the least common, but they do connect the very basic things. The left-hand indicator, the right-hand indicator, a return to earth, your brake lights, and your tail lights, including clearance and side lights. Next up is the 7-pin, which comes in flat or round. In the round, you can get a big or a small. Usually the big is used on trucks or heavy machinery that have a lot more lights and require more power to be fed through the plug. The 7-pin connects all of the things that we mentioned with the 5-pin, plus reverse lights and electronic brake controller. We prefer using the flat over the round as the wiring is more likely to get damaged on the round. Also, you can plug a 7-pin flat into a 12-pin flat. On the tow vehicle, our preference is to mount a 12-pin flat, as then if you tow a trailer or caravan that has either a 7-pin flat or 12-pin flat, both of these can plug into the 12-pin on your car. Next up, we have the 12-pin plug. You get everything that you connected on the 5 and 7, plus you now have 5 extra pins to wire up various accessories like a fridge ignition feed to power the fridge in your caravan or trailer while you're driving, a breakaway battery monitor allows the voltage of the battery on your breakaway unit to be displayed on the dash of your vehicle. ESC, which is electronic stability control, if your caravan has it, or a heavy earth return. Each caravan and trailer manufacturer wires up the plug differently. We always request a wiring diagram from the caravan or trailer manufacturer to confirm what needs to be wired to what pin. Lastly, we have the Anderson plugs. The Anderson plug is most commonly used to charge the batteries in your trailer or caravan when you are driving. You can do this via a 12-pin plug, but we don't recommend it, as the power that is fed into the plug to charge the batteries is generally more than a 12-pin plug can handle. We regularly see melted 12-pin plugs when people charge the batteries via them. You can get the Anderson plug in grey, red, or blue. Each coloured plug does not physically fit into the other colour. You use a different colour to ensure you plug them into the right device. When it comes to getting your vehicle wired up to tow a trailer or caravan, there are a few things we recommend. If you plan to tow a caravan, we usually suggest getting an Anderson plug installed, especially if you want to charge your caravan's battery from your vehicle. 12-pin plugs are not designed to hold a charge feed and will usually melt when exposed to that much current. If you have any other questions about the plugs your car, caravan or trailer needs, comment below or call us on 1300 227 353 or email info@amae.net.au.